Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum salam.
I'm a science graduate. Brother, my question is, generally the parents today are finding it very difficult to control the children. And many a times the children are not just becoming disobedient, but are even revolting. What is the best Islamic way to tackle this problem?
MashaAllah, sister has asked a very good question. She said that in our time, we find a very big challenge today in the form of children who are not merely disobeying the parents, but they are also sometimes revolting the parents. In such situations, what is the best way to find an Islamic solution for it? Sister, MashaAllah, I think the time is for Maghrib Salah very near, and I may not be able to give the answer in a very justified manner, but I'll try my level best with Allah's help to explain as much as possible. Sister, the first and foremost problem today, because you said today, the time period mentioned in our time today, the first and foremost problem is not the children, it is the parents themselves. The children find the parents not performing 5 times salah. The children find the parents speaking lies. The children find the parents going to movies. The children find the parents watching naked dances and music and every other bloody thing on the television sets, on their LEDs. The children find the parents speaking foul language. The children find the parents backbiting about others. The children find the parents greedily encouraging them to earn this world. The children find the parents never reading the Quran. The children find the parents never reading the Quran with an understanding. The children find the parents that even if somebody says, this is what Allah says in the Quran, this is what Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say, they immediately say, oh come on bhai, this life is different, this life is different. So what are the children learning? They are learning their mother and their father disobeying and revolting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, I will make you taste your own medicine now. You disobeyed me, now you see I will make your son disobey you. You disobeyed me, I will make your daughter disobey you. And most of the times, when our parents are correcting us, the correction is not because of Quran and Hadith. It is because of their self-esteem. You know, if you do this tomorrow, what will the people say to me? You look, your son did this. Who are you, bloody? Who are you? Who are you in Islam? The izzat is of Allah and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's it. The izzat is only for Allah and His Messenger, not for you. Who are you? You know, many times my wife, my first wife, she tells to my children, you know, bete, your papa is doing this work, so don't do anything. People, I always tell, my children are here, he's there, my son is there. You ask him, I always tell my wife, don't correct him that way. Don't correct him that way. Who is Imran? Bloody, I mean, throw me in a garbage. Who am I? I'm nothing. The izzat is for Allah and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I say, tell my son, I tell my wife, tell him that, bete, if you do this, this will bring a bad name to Allah, His Nabi, and to this Ummat. Don't do that. Because Allah, Nabi, and the Ummat is ultimate, not parents. Who are parents? Allah can give you birth without any parents. He can give a female dog give a birth to a human being. For Allah, there is nothing impossible. The parents, when they correct, their correction is not according to Islam. The mother herself, she is backbiting so much about others. She is the one who goes out to purchase dresses which are naked dresses for the children. She is the one who says, "Ab bete burqa ab itta mat pehno. Come on, remove the burqa in the marriages." There is video shooting. Who is encouraging the daughter to become like a prostitute? My words may sound very hard. I don't mind it, man. If you are asking a Muslim girl to remove the hijab, for us Muslims, it's a ghira matter. It's a matter of our ghira. We can't see our sisters removing their hijab. We can't see that. Let the whole world go to hell. I damn care it. My Allah, my Nabi said, our women should be in hijab. That is their respect if they are in hijab. If they are not in hijab, I again don't want to repeat that word. But who makes them like that? The mother and the father. I know several in IREF who have come to tell me that we want to wear hijab, Imran bhai. My father says don't wear it. Why are they revolting? Because the parents are revolting Allah. Why are they revolting? The parents are revolting Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. See the children, I know so many of the children today, they go out from India to Australia to London, from Delhi they come here, from Hyderabad they go to Delhi. For why? Reason, the girls are going for higher education. Are you shameless? Are you shameless? Your sending your daughter in a society 24/7, nobody knows what's happening there. And you just trust. No, I trust my daughter. Keep trusting till she goes to an abortion center for abortion. Am I joking? Shame on such parents. The problem are the parents today. All the talks today, the parents, it sounds very good to their ears. Saab, humare bacche ke baare, bacche ko zara samjhaiye maa baap ki farmabardari kya hoti. I said, pehle tum samjho Allah Rasool ki farmabardari kya hoti, usko khud samajh mein aati maa baap ki farmabardari kya hoti. First, you learn to obey Allah and His Nabi, your child will definitely obey you, Allah will make them obey you. What is, you don't even ask your children to read duas, because you don't know the dua. When they are sleeping on the bed, you don't know. When you wake up, you don't know. When do you wake up? You have made Fajr haram for yourself. You don't even keep an alarm for Fajr. Wallah, I swear by Allah. I'm not proudly trying to boast it. Subhanallah, it's Allah's help. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help me more and my family. Any one of you, any time at random, come to my house in Fajr, you will find all my children awake. I will kill them, I'll kick them out of the house if they don't do that. I never beat my children. I never scold my children. Except when it comes to this. Ask them. All my children are here. Give them, swear by Allah and ask them to say that. I never do that. I say, if you leave Salah or do anything which is against Allah's book, I will kill you. I don't mind it going to jail after that. I'm not going to spare you. The parents, bete, if you don't pass in this exam, you see what I will do to you. Have you ever stressed that so much for Islam? Have you done that? Who are at fault? The parents, not the children. Sister, the parents should be corrected first. They should learn what is Quran and Hadith first. They should dress themselves properly. When these children, all of you, when your mothers and your sisters, please introspect your mothers and your sisters. Look at the dress code they wear in the marriage functions. Why? Will your mother be given an exception on Day of Jannat? Your sister will be given an exception on Day of Jannat? She's better than Bibi Fatima and our Ummahatul Mu'mineen, that whatever dress code she wears, Allah will do nothing to her? Shame on us! If our parents don't know that, you teach them if they don't know that. Shame on these mothers. They wear new dresses. They purchase new dresses for the girls. Half sleeves. Transparent sleeves. Oh, anyway, she's covering till here. So Allah wants you to cover till here on Day of Judgment. Oh, come on Allah, you are a little extremist. You will say, Nauzubillah. What are you doing? Wallah, this is not something to laugh. Wallah, imagine that day. When Allah is saying that day, when the hearts of the people will flow till their throats, the severity will be such, their hearts will be in their throats. And Allah will ask, didn't you know that today you are going to stand before me and me alone? You are not afraid of that, sisters? You are making your daughters nude. You brothers, you are shameless today. Because you are into affairs with other girls, you know your sister is in an affair, you don't mind it. Where do you mind it? When she wants to do something halal, then the problem comes to you. She comes to say, I want to marry this person. How can you say you want to marry that person? Are we dead? There Allah is saying, let her marry according to her choice. There you have your ego. Everything we are doing opposite to Allah and His Rasul. If somebody's sister comes tomorrow and she says, I want to become somebody's fourth wife, will you be quiet? She says, I want to marry a person who is 70, 80 years old, will you be quiet? You look, you will be the first one to oppose Quran and Hadith after that. You will be the first one to oppose it. Allah is saying no issues with Allah. Allah is saying her choice. When Islam didn't put any restriction, you people put so many restrictions in so many things. And where Islam put restrictions, the parents remove it today. So many issues. Who should be corrected for this? For the children to be obedient and not revolting, the parents should be made obedient to Allah and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. First, by default, inshallah, the children will also become well, inshallah, after that. I hope I answered that question. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.